quarantine sanity and a calming poo. Hey, Alto Key here. Inspirations, emotions, questions from you. That's what we're going to be doing this vlog. We're going to be answering some of your questions. I put an Instagram story up and I wanted to know, what do you want to know about me? What do you want to know from me? And we're going to answer all those questions right now. Jacob Biggerstaff wants to know, what are some of my favorite artists to listen to and who gives me my inspiration? So usually what I do is put together a playlist of songs that I'm listening to, discovering new things on Spotify and things like that. And usually I listen to them again and again. I just try to get some of those ideas forming into something. In terms of artists I regularly listen to, I love anything which is kind of in the indie space, in the folk space, sometimes in the pop space, but not too poppy because, yeah. But yeah, in general, I like, recently, for example, I've been listening to Oh Wonder. I've been listening to Dodi. I've been listening to S. Carey. And these are all just artists who have very like chilled vibes and interesting sounds to their music. But sometimes I listen to bigger artists as well, like Coldplay and Bon Iver. So it's forever changing. Ohio Sayori wants to know, how do I stay sane during quarantine? I use chips. I don't know what what that means, whether it's like an American like version of crisps in the UK, or if they mean they're literally eating like fries, like potato fries, or if they're using poker chips or any of the other types of chips, like computer chips, I don't know. But I don't know what you mean. Please explain to me. For me personally, the way I stay sane in quarantine, I keep my mind active. I keep myself motivated to do more and more of the music stuff. Sometimes to my detriment, I do a little bit too much stuff on the content side sometimes, and I definitely need more sleep. That's on my like list to do. I need to get more sleep. But given I'm drinking coffee now and it's like in the evening, that's just not gonna happen. It's just not gonna happen again, but you might as well go with it. Anyway, the way I stay sane is by keeping my mind active, and I recommend you do that too. Liam Feeney 64 wants to know, what is my target as a musician? Love the music, Alto Koala. Thank you so much. It's tough like to know where we're going. We're leaves in the wind. But in terms of my music career, obviously there's got to be some end goal, right? All right. I don't know. The point is, for me personally, I just want to get my music out there in as many ways as I possibly can and grow as an artist. One target I would love to have is to become like financially independent and be able to do the music like pretty much all the time. It's just very, very hard to do that because obviously money, you need it to live. And I guess in terms of small term, like short term goals, some things I'm aiming for, I would love to aim to get 6 singles out this year, but it really depends on everything else, like so much out of my control. You know, like I need to work with other people, what are their schedules like. But I think a good target always to have is just to release more music and to grow as an artist and adapt and learn. I have always changed up everything I'm doing, like all the time. I'm always learning the best social media strategies. I'm always learning how to improve my music, my sounds, getting new equipment. I guess part of me hopes that if I keep doing that improvement process, things will naturally get better as a result of it. It's kind of like, what effort do you put in? What sort of stuff do you get out sort of situation, you know? So from that point of view, I don't know what the end target is. To become massive, maybe, maybe not. To get my music out there, hell yeah. Tyler Zamprogno, let me know if I pronounced that right, wants to know, what's my favorite thing to do that calms me down? I love eating and watching TV. That always gets me in a very chilled state, especially if I eat like lots of food. A nice poo. Who doesn't enjoy a nice poo? in terms of stuff that like, maybe the question should be more like, what do I do when I'm stressing and overthinking? That's maybe like another way to tackle the question. And for me personally, I try to like remember the realism of it, what I am capable of doing, who I am, you know, all those kind of things that ground me and put me back into perspective of like where I am. So for example, if my social media isn't going well, which often it isn't for one reason or another, I get myself in a bit of a state, what do I need to do? Is it all failing? Oh, what do I do? But then I like bring myself back and say, okay, like, what are some strategies I can do? What do I know that works? What can I do to start bringing things back more on track? So maybe that corresponds to some kind of psychological technique. I don't know, like people mention grounding and breathing deeply and all that stuff. I don't do any of that, but I do like always try to like bring it back to like focus and like, what can I realistically do right now. So there we go, that was some questions, and feel free to keep reaching out to me with questions. I love to answer questions and have a bit of a chat. But in the meantime, don't you forget to like, subscribe, ring the bell for notifications, and I'll see you next time. Bye!